Welcome people. In this video we want to look at dengue virus. It's you can call it as dengue or dengue virus, your choice, however you think is fancy. So dengue is caused by virus or by the mosquito? Finally, it is the virus that enters our body and causes the problem, correct? Mosquito is just the vector. Which is the mosquito? It is Aedes mosquito. Aedes mosquito, when it rests on a surface, it will be parallel to the surface. So vector is mosquito. It is Aedes aegypti or Aedes albopictus. How do you want to pronounce this? Let's see.
Aedes aegypti, Aedes albopictus.
They're calling it as aegypti. Looks like this A is silent.
Albopictus.
Okay, thank you so much. So these mosquitoes bite during the day and Aedes mosquito transfers the virus even to its offsprings. Okay, not just to us, even to its offsprings it will pass. There are 5 serotypes: Den 1, Den 2, Den 3, Den 4, Den 5. Den 5 is not in India yet. So Den 1, Den 2, Den 3, Den 4. In that Den 2 is very dangerous, they say. Especially when Den 1 comes and then Den 2 comes, it's even more dangerous. Okay. So this dengue is endemic in more than 100 countries. Especially in India also we have a lot of dengue menace. Now look at the virus, what dengue virus is. This is from our virus classification video. There we have seen that RNA virus. In RNA virus you have arbovirus. Under arbovirus you have flaviviridae. Arbovirus, flaviviridae, mosquito transmitted. There you have hemorrhagic group. There you have dengue virus and then yellow fever virus. Other types of, other than hemorrhagic, you have encephalitis group, that is Japanese encephalitis virus. So dengue virus, can you tell where exactly it comes? Dengue virus is a RNA virus, it is arbovirus, it is flaviviridae, mosquito transmitted, hemorrhagic. Wow, very good, excellent. So RNA virus, arbovirus, flaviviridae, mosquito transmitted, hemorrhagic. Excellent, excellent. Okay, now let's move on. Okay, let's make this small. Moving on. The pathogenesis of dengue virus. See, there is something called as primary dengue infection and secondary dengue infection. Secondary infection will usually be of a different serotype and when it attacks, it will be severe. Okay. Let's move on to the details of pathogenesis. Antibody response against dengue virus. So, the infection, dengue infection produces both neutralizing and non-neutralizing antibodies. So, what these neutralizing antibodies, what our body produces, what happens? They are protective in nature. Okay, these antibodies, they are produced against the infective serotype and this will last lifelong. Okay, so it will protect as against other serotypes also for some time. Is it clear or not? So neutralizing antibodies against the infecting serotype protects lifelong, okay, and against other serotypes protects for some time. Is it clear? How many people are sleeping? What are we saying? We are saying that the antibodies which are produced, these neutralizing antibodies, usually they protect lifelong against the infecting serotype. Okay, let's move on to non-neutralizing antibodies now. Now, non-neutralizing antibodies, these also last lifelong and they are heterotypic in nature and they are produced against other serotypes but not against infective serotype. How strange, huh? So, it is against the other serotypes, okay? So, what happens? The first infection, okay, fine, this person will recover. But the second infection, what happens when there is a second dengue infection, these whatever non-neutralizing antibodies which were produced, these are going to, they are not going to protect us, they are going to harm us. The non-neutralizing antibodies which were produced are going to bind, okay, to the second serotype and they are going to protect them from the host immune. That is why second attack of dengue is very severe. Okay, we had seen this already before. See here, secondary dengue infection, different serotype is going to be very severe because of this antibody dependent enhancement, ADE. This term you should not forget, ADE. Where will ADE? You will see antibody dependent enhancement in dengue. Okay, let's take a notes, wait. Give us a pin up, or you had that kind of notes, right? Let's just see what and all we have seen so far and make some notes, wait. Till now, what and all special words you saw? Special words, anything specific, very specific to dengue? This one only. ADE, where do you see ADE? Antibody dependent, bad idea. Antibody dependent enhancement, okay, ADE. In dengue, some special words you should know. Dengue, some specific words, ADE. Okay, antibody dependent enhancements. Let's move on. The WHO classification, this is the old one. You used to have dengue fever, that is DF, and then dengue hemorrhagic fever and dengue shock syndrome. All are usually in children. Okay, these. Dengue fever can be in adults. Just look at this. Dengue fever, it is characterized by abrupt onset of high fever. It is called as biphasic fever, right? Biphasic fever or breakbone fever or saddleback fever. Okay, this is sudden abrupt onset of high fever. Abrupt onset of high fever. Okay. Then here you will have maculopapular rashes all over the chest and upper limb. Okay. So, tell yourself, chest, upper limb, if there are rashes, could be dengue. Okay. Then, what rashes? Maculopapular rashes, you should say correctly. Maculopapular rashes all over the chest and upper limbs. Then you can have severe frontal headache. Frontal headache, remember, where's the headache? Frontal headache. Then muscle pain, joint pain, lymph adenopathy, retroorbital pain, loss of appetite, nausea, vomiting, all that's very common, correct? So let's just add those points. Okay, so now we want to move on to the next one, dengue hemorrhagic fever, DHF. So we saw that dengue hemorrhagic fever and dengue shock syndrome are usually affecting children. Just let's look at what this thing is saying. Serotype 1 followed by serotype 2 seems to be more dangerous and can develop into dengue hemorrhagic fever and dengue shock syndrome more often. Okay, so if serotype 2 follows serotype 1, there is more problem. Let's add this point here. Serotype 1 followed by serotype 2 seems to be more dangerous. Okay, so let's go back now. We are here, we have finished dengue fever. Now let us look at dengue hemorrhagic fever. Fine. Take a break. Let's look at this. Dengue hemorrhagic fever. Here what happens, it is characterized by high grade continuous fever. Here there is high grade continuous fever in this case. Hepatomegaly, thrombocytopenia, platelet count decreases less than 1 lakh per millimeter cube. Raised hematocrit, that is the packed cell volume, is raised by 20%. Why did the packed cell volume increase? Evidence of hemorrhage can be detected by positive tourniquet test. Positive tourniquet test will tell you about hemorrhage. Spontaneous bleeding will be there from skin, nose, mouth and gums. Okay, so what did you understand? So now we are actually discussing dengue hemorrhagic fever. Okay. So now what happens in this? There is high grade continuous fever, hepatomegaly, then thrombocytopenia. So thrombocytopenia means the platelet count will reduce less than 1 lakh per millimeter cube. Okay. So thrombocytopenia, platelet count is less than 1 lakh per millimeter cube. So this diagram is representing thrombocytopenia. This should remind you. Raised hematocrit, this is kind of a surprise for me. Why is there raised hematocrit? Okay. Packed cell volume increases by 20%. Evidence of hemorrhage can be detected. So hemorrhage, definitely hemorrhage will be there. So how will you detect hemorrhage? A positive tourniquet test, so greater than 20 petechial spots per square inch area in cubital fossa. So you know what a tourniquet is? They will apply kind of a tight band around the, let's say, the bicep. Then what will happen around the cubital fossa? They will see that there are greater than 20 petechial spots, okay, per square inch. So this they will tell is a hemorrhagic evidence. Then they can have spontaneous bleeding from skin, nose, mouth and gums. Okay, so all these are going to be dengue hemorrhagic fever. Say what and all you saw till now. Dengue hemorrhagic fever, what and all you learned? High grade continuous fever, hepatomegaly. Touch your liver. Yes, touch it and say hepatomegaly. In the first dengue fever, it was chest and upper limbs. Now it is liver, hepatomegaly. Thrombocytopenia, all the platelets went off. Platelet count decreased. The packed cell volume but increased. And there's hemorrhage. And you can detect hemorrhage by positive tourniquet test. Or you can see spontaneous bleeding anywhere and everywhere that indicates hemorrhage. Right? So dengue is called? It's dengue is under the hemorrhagic group of virus. Correct? DHF. Dengue hemorrhagic fever will come for exam, so you should know these details. Let's move on. Now let us move on to dengue shock syndrome. It usually affects children. So dengue shock syndrome is, what will you say if what will you give the short form as? Who will say correctly? Dengue shock syndrome. DSS, of course. DSS, according to the textbook. So here, what happens, all the above criteria of dengue hemorrhagic fever, you know, all the criteria of dengue hemorrhagic fever will be present. In addition to this, there is manifestations of shock. Okay. All DHF symptoms present plus shock manifestations. Okay, what are the shock manifestations? Rapid and weak pulse. Rapid pulse, weak pulse. Then, rapid pulse, weak pulse. Narrow pulse pressure. So, pulse pressure is less. Okay, or hypotension. What is the normal pulse pressure? Pulse pressure is 40, right? So, there is less or a narrow pulse pressure, hypotension, restlessness. So in dengue shock syndrome, what and all you're seeing? Shock is there now. So all the symptoms of DHF are present. Along with it, there are shock manifestations like rapid pulse, weak pulse, narrow pulse pressure, hypotension. Definitely this person is restless and is in shock. Okay. So can you revise this and tell me what and all you saw in DSS? Rapid pulse, weak pulse, narrow pulse pressure, restlessness, skin will be cold and clammy. Very good. Hypotension. Very good. Very good. Okay. So this was the previous classification, or actually this was the previous classification by WHO. Now the current classification is dengue and severe dengue. Dengue without and with warning signs, and then severe dengue. Okay. Currently this is the classification. This is the photo from WHO, I think. So look at this, dengue with or without warning signs, and this is severe dengue. So without warning signs means what? With warning signs means what? Warning signs are something like this. Take a break, take a deep breath. Okay, now we are going to read the warning signs of dengue. Okay, are you able to see? So you have abdominal pain, tenderness. Touch your stomach and say abdominal pain, dengue. Vomiting, clinical fluid accumulation, mucosal bleed because it's hemorrhagic fever, lethargy, restlessness, liver enlargement, hepatomegaly, increase in HCT concurrent with rapid decrease in platelet count. What is HCT? It's written here, hematocrit will increase, but platelet count will decrease. So this is interesting. I want to highlight this. How do I highlight it? So warning signs are pretty clear for you. Abdominal pain, vomiting, persistent vomiting, bleeding, liver enlargement, increase in the hematocrit, but a decrease in platelet count. This is something you have to pay attention to. Let's move on to the criteria for severe dengue. For severe dengue, what and all should be there? Severe plasma leakage leading to shock, that is DSS, fluid accumulation with respiratory distress. This person has respiratory distress. Severe bleeding, liver, AST, ALT, some value. CNS is affected, heart and other organs are affected. Okay. So, can you tell, according to the new classification, what are the severe criteria for severe dengue? Severe dengue, CNS involvement, heart, liver, AST, ALT, something will be more. Shock will be there. Then hemorrhage, severe bleeding, respiratory distress will be there. Okay. I think let's mark all that. Hold on. Now look at this basic things that we did not see without warning symptoms. Nausea, vomiting, rash, tourniquet test positive. So if tourniquet test positive, it is just a without warning sign dengue. Any warning sign they have put. Okay. Take a deep breath. Take a break. Let's continue with other details. See, still how much is left, you know. Prevention, lab diagnosis, treatment is left. So let's do one thing. We'll continue in the next video. So just for now, just review what we have seen so far. Hope it's clear for you. So three things: dengue fever, dengue hemorrhagic fever, dengue shock syndrome. Currently dengue without or with warning signs, severe dengue. These are the criteria. So tourniquet test positive is actually probable dengue. Warning signs will be liver enlargement more than 2 cm, so specifically they have given. Prevention, lab diagnosis, and treatment in the next video. See you. Bye bye.